Hello children, I hope you are all happy and safe. Welcome to this special English hour. Here we will sing, dance, listen to stories and have lots of fun together. Are you ready to have fun? Then please stand up and dance along with me. Bachcho, TV ke nazdeek aa jaiye aur mere saath ek dance mein jud jaiye.
Scooby-Dooby, jump, jump, jump. Scooby-Dooby, walk, walk, walk. Scooby-Dooby, dance, dance, dance. Scooby-Dooby, roll, roll, roll. Scooby-Dooby, jump, jump, jump. Scooby-Dooby, walk, walk, walk. Scooby-Dooby, dance, dance, dance. Scooby-Dooby, roll, roll, roll. Scooby-Dooby, jump, jump, jump. Scooby-Dooby, walk, walk, walk. Scooby-Dooby, dance, dance, dance. Scooby-Dooby, everybody roll.
Okay children, I hope you enjoyed the dance we just did. Now I would like to ask you a few questions. Let us share our thoughts and ideas. Bachcho, ab main aapse kuch sawal karungi aur hum apne thoughts aur ideas share karenge. What does nature give us? Prakriti matlab nature hame kya deti hai? Nature gives us sunlight, gives us fresh air, gives us water, gives us flowers, gives us fruits. Nature gives us so many beautiful things. Now tell me, what do honeybees give us? Madhumakhi hame kya deti hai? Yes, honeybees give us honey. Where do honeybees stay? Madhumakhiyan kahan rehti hain? Honeybees stay in a honeycomb. Honeycomb is made from beeswax. What is inside a honeycomb? Madhumakhi ke chhatte ke andar kya milta hai? Honey is found inside the honeycomb. Children, now that we have spoken so much about honeybees, let's hear what the honeybee has to say. We will be reading the lesson. A honeybee speaks. Please open page number 17 of your English Bal Bharati textbook. If you have a textbook, please point to the words as I read. And if you don't have a textbook, please listen carefully. What is it that you see in the picture? Yes, there are many honeybees. What are the honeybees doing? The honeybees are pouring honey into the honeycomb. What is it that you see here? Yes, it is the honeycomb. Okay then children, let's begin reading. A honeybee speaks. A monologue. What? Me? A lazy bee? You think I simply have fun all day among the flowers? Oh no! When I am flitting from flower to flower, I am actually very hard at work. And that's why I am called not a lazy bee, but a busy bee. Come, I'll show you my house and tell you what a lot of work we bees do all our life. My house is called a honeycomb. It's a big house with thousands of rooms or cells. Each room has 6 equal sides. We take a lot of care to build it. We even produce the material for building the comb. It's called beeswax. Where does the honeybee stay? Madhumakhi kahan rehti hai? The honeybee stays in a honeycomb. What is the honeycomb made of? The honeycomb is made of beeswax. How does the honeycomb look? The honeycomb looks like this. It has many rooms or cells. Can you see these cells? Each of these cells has 6 equal sides. Do you know, when I was very young, I used to stay at home. But even then, I had to do a lot of work. I had to look after the larva, the babies that would grow into bees. I had to feed them and protect them. If anyone came near our comb to disturb it, I was ready with my weapon, a sting. I am not only a worker, I am also a soldier. Beware, don't trouble me. When the honeybee was small, was young, what would she do? जब मधुमक्खी छोटी थी तब वो क्या करती थी? The honeybee would stay at the honeycomb and take care of the larva. Larva are babies that grow into bees. Why is the honeybee called a soldier? The honeybee is called a soldier because she protects her honeycomb. If anyone comes to disturb their honeycomb, the bee is ready with its sting. Well, to go back to the comb, I had to keep the comb cool by fanning it with my wings. Then I had to keep the house in order, put away all the honey and food that other bees brought from the flowers. But luckily, I had hundreds of other bees working with me. We all worked together without ever fighting. That's one reason why we can build such perfect and beautiful houses. What would all the honeybees do in the honeycomb? Madhumakhiyan chhatte par kya karti thi? All the honeybees together would make sure to keep the comb cool by continuously fanning it with their wings. What would all the honeybees do in the honeycomb? मधुमक्खी के छत्ते में मधुमक्खियां क्या करती थी? The honey bees would take care of the food and the honey that all the other bees brought. They would organize it and keep it properly. The honeybees would protect the honeycomb. The honeybees never fought amongst themselves, and that is how they built such a strong honeycomb. Yes, I helped with the house building too. We keep making our house bigger and bigger to make room for the babies and for the food and honey we gather. When I became older, I began to fly out of the comb to gather nectar. I take the nectar and pollen from the flowers and carry them back to the comb. Nectar is the sweet juice in flowers, and pollen is the yellow powdery stuff you see on flowers. I visit hundreds of flowers and make several trips every day without wasting even a single moment. The nectar from the flowers is too thin. We bees turn it into the sweet thick honey that you like. It's only because you called me a lazy bee that I stopped and explained it all to you. Otherwise, I have not a moment to lose. Bye! What do honey bees gather from flowers? मधुमक्खियां फूलों से क्या इकट्ठा करती हैं? Honey bees gather nectar and pollen from flowers and take it back to their honeycomb. What is nectar? Nectar is the sweet juice found in flowers. What is pollen? Pollen is the little yellow powder that you see on flowers. What do honeybees do using nectar from the flowers? Honeybees use nectar from the flowers, which is thin. They turn it into a thick liquid, which is honey, that you all like so much. Okay, children, now that we have heard what the honeybee had to say, what do you think? Are honeybees lazy or hardworking? Yes, sure, they are very hardworking. And there is so much that we can learn from honeybees. Children, now let us have a look at the new words we learned today. Nectar, nectar, nectar. Honeybees suck nectar from flowers. Nectar is the sweet juice found inside flowers. Second word, pollen, pollen. Pollen. Pollen is the yellow powder found on flowers. Honeybees collect pollen from flowers. Honeycomb. 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 Bees live in a honeycomb. Honeycomb has many cells. Weapon. 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 Honeybees use their sting as a weapon. A weapon can harm another person. Okay, children, I hope you enjoyed reading today's lesson. We heard so much about bees. We learned how busy bees are. Every animal has some special quality. Here, I would like to give you the names of some more animals and would like you to make sentences using the name of the animal and the special qualities they hold. Let me give you an example. If you are given the name of the animal, lion, what quality do you find in a lion? What kind of a sentence can we make? A lion has a loud roar. The lion is the king of the forest. In this way, you will get the names of other animals. You have to think of a quality of that animal and frame two sentences. Are you ready? Then let's begin. Now let's check out some of the sentences I have written. Elephant. Elephants have a big trunk. Elephants have big teeth. Ant. Ants work together. Ants collect food in winter and store it. Fox. A fox can be very cunning. There are many stories on how a fox cheats other animals. Tortoise. A tortoise lives in its shell. Tortoise walk very slowly. Monkey. Monkey loves to eat bananas. Monkey loves to play on the tree. Butterfly. A butterfly sits on flowers. A butterfly has beautiful colors on its wings. Cow. Cows help farmers on their farm. Cows give us milk. Horse. A horse is used for riding. The horse runs very fast. Okay children, I hope you enjoyed today's session. Now it's time to sit back and enjoy while I tell you a wonderful story. Have you ever got a chance to be to a forest? I have been to a forest and it is beautiful. What do we find in a forest? We find all kinds of different animals. Would you like to hear a story about all these different animals? Okay then, today I am going to read to you The Evil Forest and it is written by Joseph Nedimo. This is the story of a beautiful village named Nyare. Nyare had many snakes, but the longest and the biggest snake was Lego. Lego could eat a whole goat and a sheep at one go. One day in Nyare village, there were three little girls, Apio, Ajo and Atino. They three were going to the forest to bring firewood. Their grandmother told them, "Beware of the snake Lego. Only bring firewood and come back home." Ajo did not pay attention. Ek din Nyare gaon mein Apio, Ajo, अतीनो नाम की तीन लड़कियां थी। वो जंगल में लकड़ी लेने जा रही थी। उनकी दादी ने उन्हें अच्छे से समझाया था कि सांप का ध्यान रखे और केवल लकड़ी लेकर तुरंत घर वापस आ जाए। लेकिन उनमें से एक लड़की अजो ने बिल्कुल ध्यान नहीं दिया। The girls prepared to go to the forest. They packed food, They packed ropes and they packed a sharp machete. तीनों लड़कियों ने जंगल में जाने की तैयारी की. When the girls reached the forest, they saw Lego's golden teeth. Atino said, "Come, let us take Lego's teeth so that he can harm no one else again." Apio said, "Don't you remember what Grandma said? We have to only fetch firewood and go back to the village." जंगल में आने पर लड़कियों ने देखा कि लेगो सांप के दांत वहां पड़े हुए थे. अतीनो ने कहा कि चलो हम ये दांत ले चलते हैं, लेकिन अपियो ने उन्हें वापस समझाया कि नहीं, दादी ने कहा है सिर्फ लकड़ी लेकर जंगल से हमें वापस चलना है, बाकी और कोई चीज नहीं लेनी है. अजो सेड, "Grandma doesn't know anything. I will take the golden teeth." Atino and Apio were not happy. Tino behnon mein se Ajo ne kaha ki main ye daant le chalungi. Dadi maa ko kuch nahi pata. Baki ki do behne Atino aur Apio ko ye baat bilkul achhi nahi lagi. Lego the snake came there looking for his teeth. When he did not find them, he said, "The one who has taken my teeth must surely know who I am." Lego saap jab wahan par pahuncha aur usne dekha ki uske daant wahan par nahi the, usne socha, "Ye zarur kisi aise insaan ka kaam hai jo mujhe janta hai." When the girls had collected all the firewood and were leaving from the forest, they suddenly heard a noise. Hiss, hiss. Lego the snake came in front of them and all the girls were scared. They threw away everything that was in their hand. Lego the snake opened his mouth wide and the girls were scared. He asked, "Who has taken my teeth?" "The girl who has taken my teeth will not be able to sing. The thief who has robbed my teeth will not be able to sing. But the one who is innocent, who has not done anything wrong, will be able to sing well." The first one to sing was Apio. Apio sang well and said, "I have not taken your teeth. The one who has taken your teeth is near." After Apio, Atino also sang. She too sang well. When Ajo's turn came, words were not coming out from her mouth. She was very scared. Lego now knew that it was Ajo who had taken his teeth. जब तीसरी लड़की अजो का मौका आया, तब वो इतना कांप रही थी कि वो गा नहीं पाई. ये देखकर लेगो सांप को तुरंत पता चल गया कि उसी लड़की ने उसके दांत लिए थे. लेगो द स्नेक स्वॉलोड अजो. द अदर टू सिस्टर्स Apio and Atino ran back home and told their grandmother. Their grandmother replied saying, "Only if Ajo had listened to me." कहानी में लेगो सांप अजो को पूरी तरह निगल लेता है. बाकी की दो बहनें अपियो और अतीनो दौड़कर गांव जाती हैं और अपनी दादी माँ से पूरी कहानी कहती हैं. दादी माँ कहती हैं कि अजो ने अगर उनकी बात सुनी होती तो ऐसा नहीं होता. Dear children, I hope you liked this story. I know it was a little scary, but don't worry. It's just a story and not reality. Okay, children, I hope you all liked the singing and dancing we did today. I would like you all to once again read the lesson, A Honeybee Speaks, and share the story with your family members. You can also draw the picture of a honeycomb and show it to your friends. Children, till we meet next, take care, bye-bye, and stay safe. Thank you.